Hello, everyone. Extracting LoRA from a checkpoint and reversing the LoRA effect can be complex tasks, especially for those interested in stable diffusion and AI art. But fret not! If you're passionate about stable diffusion and LoRA training in the realm of AI art, we have the solution you need. In this YouTube video, we'll guide you step by step on how to extract LoRA from a checkpoint and reverse the captivating LoRA effect effortlessly. So, if you're ready to unlock the secrets of stable diffusion and create mesmerizing AI art with LoRA, stay tuned, and let's dive right in. Before we dive into today's topic, we want to take a moment to ask you to subscribe to our channel and hit the like button below. Are you ready? Today, we will talk about extracting LoRA from a checkpoint and reversing the LoRA effect. We will follow the chain of thoughts technique to solve the problem. Let's see what the problem is. When we create AI girls using some checkpoints like Chill Out Mix, most of the time, we will get some not safe for work images as results. That's no problem if you are trying to get that results, but sometimes it is too much that you need to spend some time to delete those images. For example, all that three images are not safe for work. My first thought is to extract a LoRA model from a checkpoint and apply it to the negative prompt. For illustration purposes, we are going to use a Pixar style model to do the demo. So my action would be to extract a LoRA model from the Pixar style model checkpoint and apply it to the negative prompt. Let's see how we can extract the LoRA model. If you have not watched the merging LoRA video before, you can find the link here or in the description below. Like last time, I created a folder called Extract to do the conversion. I also created a bash script file to run the command. In the network folder under the SD scripts folder, there is a script called extract-lora-from-models.python file. We will use that script to do the extraction. In the bash script, I changed the directory to the SD scripts directory. And then run the Python script extract-lora-from-models.python. Next, activate the correct conda environment. Add execution permission to the bash script. And then run it. Okay, this is the help messages. Copy them to the bash script to have a look. There is a save precision parameter. We will choose FP16. Model original, usually the original model would be the version 1.5 pruned in my only safe tenters. Model tune, it would be the fine-tune model. This time, it is the Pixar style model. Let the output LoRA model be saved in a working directory. The network dimension is set to 128. We are not using conv.twat. We use CPU only. Okay, it should be fine. Let's run it. Loading the original model. Loading the tune model. All parameters are matched. How long does it take? About 1 minute. Okay, the LoRA model is here. We copy and paste it to the stable diffusion web UI LoRA folder. Let's test it out. I have already prepared a prompt. Generate the image. Okay, this is obviously a pixel style. What we are going to do is to put our LoRA model to the negative prompt. Everything kept the same. Let's test it out. This is the result. It is a bit different, but the overall style is still the pixel style. Hey there. If you're enjoying the content so far, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. By hitting that subscribe button, you'll be the first to know when we release new videos. Don't forget to turn on notifications as well, so you never miss out. Observation. The method seems not working. Next thought. What about reversing the original model with a fine-tuned model? Also, put it in the positive prompt instead of the negative prompt. Like the flow of the diagram here. So the next action would be to extract a LoRA model from the version 1.5 pruned MAT-only checkpoint and apply it to the positive prompt. Okay, so what we need to do is to swap the model original with the model tuned. The model original would be the pixel style model. The model fine-tuned would be the version 1.5 pruned MAT-only checkpoint. Let's give the output another name, with the word reverse in the file name. Let's run it. Okay, the LoRA model is here. We copy and paste it to the stable diffusion web UI LoRA folder. This time, remove the LoRA in the negative prompt. And put the reverse LoRA model to the positive prompt. Everything kept the same. Let's test it out. This is the result. This time, the image looks so different. It's not like the previous Pixar style image. Seems like the reverse LoRA model is doing some job. Observation. This method seems working fine. Next thought. Let's try another checkpoint. This time we will use the Van Gogh diffusion checkpoint. Okay, back to the bash scripts. The model original this time would be the Van Gogh diffusion model. The model fine-tuned would be the same version 1.5 pruned to my only checkpoint. Let's run it. Okay, the LoRA model is here. We copy and paste it to the stable diffusion web UI LoRA folder. I have already prepared a prompt. The prompt is so simple. Just Van Gogh style, beautiful women at sunset. Let's see the original image. This is the beautiful woman at sunset in Van Gogh style. Very good. Let's try to put the reverse LoRA model to the positive prompt. Generate. Wow, this is actually undoing all Van Gogh styles. What about trying to change the checkpoint to the basic version 1.5 pruned to my only checkpoint? Set the LoRA weight to 0.0, so it should have no effect. Generate. Look almost the same as the previous one. The one on the left-hand side is using Van Gogh diffusion checkpoint with the reverse LoRA model. The one on the right-hand side is using version 1.5 pruned to my only checkpoint only. Observation. This method actually works. It can undo the checkpoint effect. Let's go back to our initial problem. There are so many not safe for work images generated when using chill out mix checkpoint. My thought is to find a checkpoint that is heavily not safe for work, and extract a reverse LoRA model from it. And then we put it in the positive prompt. The next action is to extract the LoRA model using the bash script as before. Observation. After using the reverse not safe for work LoRA model in the positive prompt, the AI girls really get her clothes back on. This is a big success for me. Conclusion. LoRA model can be extracted from a difference between two checkpoints. LoRA model seems to have no effect on the negative prompt. The direction of the LoRA model between two checkpoints can be reversed. I have tried to undo the NSFW for more than 20 images, and only one failed to put back the clothes on. Whoa. A reversed LoRA with weight 1.0 equals a normal LoRA with weight minus 1.0. Google Colab notebook can be found in the description. Tell us what LoRA models you extracted in the comment below. How did you use those extracted LoRA models? Please let me know in the comment below. Thank you very much. If you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about stable diffusion and LoRA training, hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss a video. I will put up the other video soon. You can also find all the models and images in my Patreon account. The link can be found in the description. Thank you and see you in the next video.